Laura Ingraham, you're cruel. Now, you deserve every bit of the boycott that you are getting. Has Parkland shooting survivor David Hogg not been through enough trauma to last a lifetime? He hid in a closet during the massacre at his Florida school. Marjorie Stoneman Douglas, and two of his little sister's best friends were killed in the slaughter of 17 innocent students and teachers. Now, he has been subjected to cyberbullying by you, Fox News host Laura Ingraham, because he confessed in an interview that he hadn't been accepted by four of his dream colleges. It's not been great for me and some of the other members of the movement, he admitted in an on-camera interview with TMZ. We got rejected by UCLA and UCSD, but at this time, we are changing the world. It is disappointing, but at this point if colleges want to support us in that, great. But if not, we're still going to change the world, David was honest. He's disappointed, like any American high school senior would be after getting rejected from his dream colleges. Did he really deserve to get heartlessly whacked for this on March 28 by a high-profile Fox News host, Laura Ingraham, who tweeted, David Hogg rejected by four colleges to which he applied and whines about it. Dinged by UCLA with a 4.1 GPA, totally predictable given acceptance rates. No, he did not. Who asked Laura to step in and bully David? And to be clear, David was not winning in his interview. He was being factual, responding clearly with specific info to the question, and he was being honest. He is disappointed, that's a natural reaction. But he didn't go on about it. He looked on the bright side and focused on how committed he is to his mission of getting stricter gun control laws across the country. Sadly, no, disgustingly, Ingraham decided to unleash another attack on David. I say, another, because David has been subjected to a series of heinous assaults by right-wing extremists and conspiracy theorists. He has been accused of not actually being in the school while gunman Nicholas Cruz was mowing down his victims, when in fact he actually posted a video of himself hiding in a classroom closet and reporting on the attack while it was going on. Then, he was called a crisis actor who was pretending to be a student. Then, he was slammed as a Hitler Youth for being one of the March for Our Lives rally student organizers in Washington, D.C. It's been a despicable campaign by NRA fans, desperate to discredit David's earnest commitment to put a stop to school massacres, once and for all. And that means his commitment to convince politicians to ban assault weapons, institute comprehensive background checks and raise the age of gun purchases to 21. When politicians send their thoughts and prayers with no action, we say, no more. And to these politicians supported by the NRA that allow the continued slaughter of our children and our future, I say, get your resumes ready, David spoke out in his speech at the Washington, D.C. March for Our Lives that drew 800,000 people. That sure must have scared Laura and her cohorts a lot. That's why she needed to take her cheap Twitter shot. Because after all, she can't argue that stopping the slaughter of children is a bad idea. She happens FYI to be a mother herself. What is the purpose of this tweet? What is wrong with you? Are you actually proud of this? Chris Evans, one of David's supporters, tweeted back at her. Yay for David, who knew immediately how to respond. He quickly did his research and posted a list of Laura Ingraham's top 12 advertisers. See the tweet above, and guess what? So many people contacted those advertisers that so far, Nutrish, TripAdvisor, Wayfair and Nestle have all pulled their ads from her program. Said Wayfair, a furniture company, the decision of an adult to personally criticize a high school student who has lost his classmates in an unspeakable tragedy is not consistent with our values. Good, thank you. I'm glad that some companies have values even if Laura Ingraham and Fox News don't. If any of you doubt David and any of the other Parkland students' deep commitments to save other students' lives, then just watch again the videos that terrified students posted as they hid in classrooms while gunshots exploded just outside. Look again at the photos of the beautiful, innocent children who were gunned down. And at the pictures of their devastated parents, siblings and friends with tears streaming down their faces. David and the other Parkland students will never forget that. And a real-life, nasty woman, Laura Ingraham, isn't going to stop them. When she later apologized and deleted her tweet, it wasn't enough for David. An apology in an effort to just save your advertisers is not enough. I will only accept your apology only if you denounce the way your network has treated my friends and I in this fight. It's time to love thy neighbor, not mudsling at children, he tweeted. I totally agree, David. And you know what, if those colleges don't want you, it's their loss. You have given so much to the entire country, and have so much more to give.